All right, so let's learn some trigonometry. Now, if you've already mastered trig, you don't have to watch this next part, but you may be entertained. And if you haven't mastered trig, well, you're in for a treat, because this is one of the branches of mathematics that we use all the time in physics, and it's really fascinating. So let's start by looking at a right triangle. Isn't that nice? With its right angle marked by a square and its three sides. Okay, so what can we learn from this triangle? Well, let's first make a copy of it. Here is a copy, identical in every way, same angles and same sides. We call that congruent. And that just means we have the same sides and the same angles. If this has a length of 7, this has a length of 7. If this has a length of 12, this has a length of 12. And likewise for the angles. What if this triangle were a little bigger? What if I were to expand it proportionally? So as it grows the same way in each direction, the same amount in each direction. Well, clearly, this is not identical to this triangle. These two are not congruent. But they are similar in some way, so let's come up with a name to describe two triangles that are similar in such a way. In fact, let's call them similar. These are similar triangles, and they're so vital to doing physics. Now, each of these triangles has three angles. This one I've labeled 1, 2, and 3. This one, 4, 5, and 6. Do they have anything in common? Are they equal? Is this statement true? That angle 1 equals 4. Angle 2 equals 5. Angle 3 equals angle 6. Check whichever of these statements are true about these two triangles.